Welcome to an example on how to use the stars and bars method of counting with the principle of inclusion and exclusion. After gym class, you are tasked with putting 14 identical balls away into 5 bins. How many ways can you complete the task with no restrictions, and how many ways can you complete the task if no bin can hold more than 6 balls? Beginning with the first question, using the stars and bars method, because we have 14 identical balls, or indistinguishable balls, we have 14 stars. And because there are 5 bins, or 5 distinguishable bins, we have 4 bars. The number of bars is always 1 less than the number of distinguishable items. And this is because each bar represents a switch, in this case, from one bin to the next. From here, any string we can form with 14 stars and 4 bars represents one possible way of completing the task with no restrictions. And the number of strings of length 18 that we can form with 14 stars and 4 bars is equal to the sum of the stars and bars choose the number of bars, which gives us 18 choose 4 ways to complete the task with no restrictions, which gives us 3,060 ways. And then for the second question, how many ways can you complete the task if no bin can hold more than 6 balls? This is going to require the principle of inclusion and exclusion. We need to subtract the ways that have more than 6 balls in each bin from the number of ways with no restrictions. We already know there are 18 choose 4 ways with no restrictions, and therefore we start by subtracting the number of ways at least one bin has at least 7 balls. And therefore we take 7 balls and place them into one of the bins, and therefore we lose 7 balls or 7 stars, leaving us with 7 stars and 4 bars. So the number of ways at least one bin has at least 7 balls is 5 choose 1 times 11 choose 4. The red 5 choose 1 is the number of ways that we can choose one bin from 5, and the blue combination 11 choose 4 is the number of ways of distributing the remaining 7 balls in the 5 bins. Again, because we have 7 stars and 4 bars. But now we have subtracted too much. We need to add back the number of ways in which at least 2 bins have at least 7 balls. So if we place 7 balls in 2 bins, we lose 14 balls or 14 stars, and we only started with 14 balls, so now we have 0 stars and 4 bars. So the number of ways in which at least 2 bins have at least 7 balls is 5 choose 2 times 4 choose 4, where the red 5 choose 2 is the number of ways we can choose 2 bins from 5, and the blue combination 4 choose 4 represents the number of ways of distributing the remaining 0 balls in the 5 bins, which is just one way. And now we are done, since it's not possible to have 7 balls in at least 3 bins, since there are only 14 balls. So the final result is below. We have 18 choose 4 minus the product of 5 choose 1 and 11 choose 4, plus the product of 5 choose 2 and 4 choose 4, which gives us 1,425 ways to complete the task if each bin can have no more than 6 balls. I hope you found this helpful.